Coming up on today's show, reports that the 2017 Chevrolet Bolt EV is already becoming discounted at some dealerships, Elon Musk drives a Model 3 release candidate, and HTT builds its first full-size Hyperloop capsule. These stories and more coming next on 10. Like all our content, today's show is funded by the in-stream ads on today's video and by the kind donations of viewers like you. Follow the link at the end of today's video to make a monthly donation to our Patreon crowdfunding campaign to help keep us independent and impartial. And if you're already donating, thanks for your continued support. It's Friday, March 24th, 2016. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and this is T.E.N, the news show that's anything but 10 minutes in length because of all the awesome news stories I've got to share with you this week. To start with, we're off to California, where Automotive News discovered this week that some Chevrolet dealers are already offering discounts for those looking to buy the recently launched Chevrolet Bolt EV. The long-range affordable plug-in, which went on sale for the first time in December and still isn't available in most of the US, suffered a drop in sales in February, causing some to question if the Bolt EV is already starting to slow in sales. But it's worth noting that while True Car recorded an average 5.3% discount off MSRP for all new Bolts sold in February, this time of year isn't the best time to buy a new car, especially an electric car, as you have to wait almost a year to claim back that $7,500 federal tax credit that comes with buying a qualifying electric car like the Bolt EV. Secondly, car sales tend to naturally drop in winter months. And finally, the California EV market is already pretty saturated with plug-in cars, so let's wait until the Bolt EV is available in more markets before we get overly concerned about those sales figures, eh? A car that will most likely not sell in any volume anytime soon is the FF91, but that's because the factory where Faraday Future says it will make its high-end, fully autonomous electric car is still nothing more than little groundwork in the desert. And that's according to Nevada's Governor's Office of Economic Development, GOED for short, which has completed the latest report on phase one of Faraday Future's planned $1 billion factory, something it's required to do since the state of Nevada originally offered up more than $335 million in tax incentives and abatements to Faraday Future for building the factory just north of Las Vegas. The report says that over $160 million has been spent thus far, paying for site demolition, grading, and moving of more than 2.5 million cubic yards of earth, and preparing the groundwork and sewerage for the massive factory. But since the factory itself should already be well underway to completion, I can't help but think Faraday Future's goal of bringing the FF91 to market in a year or so's time is just impossible. What about you? Moving forward, more positive things. We heard on Thursday from Tesla CEO Elon Musk, via Twitter of course, that Tesla's highly anticipated 8.1 software update for the Tesla Model S and Model X will roll out to cars either Tuesday or Wednesday next week. The update, which is expected to include Autopilot 2.0 improvements to give Teslas equipped with second-generation Autopilot hardware the same capabilities as cars with first-gen Autopilot hardware, has been delayed several times since its original planned December 2016 update. But it seems that this time Musk is more confident that the rollout will happen. And while some Tesla owners are skeptical they'll see the update next week, but at least it does seem, according to reports we've heard, that Tesla's previous software updates for second-gen Autopilot hardware are already a massive improvement on what went before. And this reminds us that whenever Tesla does roll out this 8.1 update, it most certainly won't be the last, because Tesla won't stop striving for perfection. Staying with Tesla for one more story, we should note the quiet announcement at the very end of last week that Tesla is discontinuing the Model S 60 and Model S 60D next month, making the Tesla Model 75 and 75Ds the new entry-level Tesla Model S's. The reason? Sales. Given the current Tesla Model S 60 and 60D are actually software-restricted versions of the Model S 75 and Model S 75D, and most people have just been skipping the 60 variants and going right to the 75s, there's really no market demand for the 60s to hang around. The bad news? Well, that puts the entry-level price of a Tesla up to $74,500 for a Model S 75, not 75D, as I incorrectly reported earlier this week in a daily vlog, something I'm sorry for getting wrong. The long and the short, if you want a Tesla Model S 60, you can still order one today, but act quick because come April 16th, Tesla won't be offering it or the 60D anymore. It's been involved in Formula E since the inaugural season, not as a racing team, but as provider of safety and medical cars. But now German automaker BMW has officially announced its intent to compete in the 2018 season of the single-seat electric race series. Why not enter this year? Well, that's because in 2018, Formula E leaves behind the rules of the first 4 years of racing and makes it possible for automakers to race in their own works cars. Cars with enough battery capacity on board to last an entire race without the weird car swap shenanigans we've seen for the 2014 through 2017 seasons. So far, BMW says it's already got FIA approval for the fifth Formula E season, the one that starts in 2018, and says it's already working hard on developing its own Formula E powertrain while working with Andretti Autosport to develop software and chassis technology. As any improvements from racing will undoubtedly make their way into production vehicles, as has been the case with Renault, I can only imagine good things will come from BMW's competitive involvement in Formula E. So get ready for a fiery race season when the German company joins the fun next year. The iconic London taxicab, complete with those big headlights and unmistakable shape, has been a permanent figure on London streets for a long time. Or, as my mother would say, since before Adam was a cowboy. And while, yes, there were electric taxicabs in London back in the early 20th century, as there were in other major cities around the world, taxicabs of more recent years have been traditionally powered by practically bomb-proof diesel engines, their unmistakable rattle forming part of London's daily background noise. But this week, production started on the TX5, a brand new London taxi cab at the London Taxi Company in Coventry, England. A cab that not only does away with the diesel engine, but combines a three-cylinder Volvo petrol engine with a good-sized lithium-ion battery pack and an electric motor to bring a range-extended electric taxi to market for the first time. Range in EV-only mode is said to be 70 miles or more, and when the battery is depleted, the onboard range extender, which operates a little like the range extender in the BMW i3 Rex, kicks into life to keep the cab running until it can be plugged in again. And while that range may not seem like much, it's worth remembering that most London cabbies drive between 20,000 and 30,000 miles per year, which, assuming they drive 5 days a week, equates to between 76 and 115 miles per day. And that means most of these new TX5 cabs will be electric most of the time. Nice! For the past few weeks, we've heard a pretty steady stream of news coming out of Tesla in relation to the Model 3 electric car, hinting that it's well on its way to hit promised late 2017 production goals. As you might remember last week, we told you that Model 3 release candidate cars were driving around San Francisco Bay after Tesla began producing them on its Fremont production line, allowing engineers to test and tweak the car's onboard software before the start of official production vehicles this autumn. Well, earlier today, Tesla CEO Elon Musk tweeted the video of him driving one of those very first Model 3 release candidates. Just 5 seconds in length, the video demonstrates a short acceleration test, but does show the Model 3 release candidate in question getting a move on, as we'd say back home. So if you're waiting for your Model 3, I think you're going to want to watch this video a few times. We're off to Chinese firm Lico next, the Chinese tech company that's responsible for much of Faraday Future's backing and is also trying to build its own electric supercar. Not to mention the company, which as a consequence of spreading it too thinly of late, has been struggling quite a lot with its finances. Something that hasn't helped Faraday Future either. Like Faraday Future, Lego wants to build a super-fast, high-tech electric car to market in the next year or so. But with it having a limited amount of cash at hand, it found itself making sacrifices of late, scaling down its vehicle production plans and trying to keep afloat in any which way it can. And this week, we learned that it's been selling land it purchased in Silicon Valley to help achieve that, selling off the 49 acres of land it purchased last year to build its US headquarters. While the land is now sold, the upside is that Lego made $10 million on the deal. But with Faraday's Future's debts and its own debts an order of magnitude larger than that, it's another nail in the coffin for the Chinese companies wanting to take on the automotive world. We're off to Toulouse, France next, where Hyperloop One's main competitor, Hyperloop Transportation Technologies, that's HTT for short, has begun building what it claims will be the world's first full-scale passenger Hyperloop capsule. Along with the announcement, there's this rather vague video detailing the whole construction process, which will result in a passenger capsule that's nearly 100 feet long and a smidgen under 9 feet wide. That's about 30 metres by 2.5 metres or thereabouts. When finished, it's claimed the capsule will weigh some 20 tonnes and be capable of transporting between 28 and 40 passengers at speeds of up to 760 miles per hour. That's 1,223 kph. The finished capsule is due to be unveiled next year, but in the meantime, don't forget to check out my video from earlier this week in which I ask what it might be like to travel by Hyperloop. It's well known among electric vehicle fans that electric car dealers are not always that plugged in when it comes to selling electric cars, either because of a lack of knowledge about EVs, apathy when it comes to learning something outside of their comfort zone, or sheer bloody-mindedness about not wanting to change their business model to welcome in the age of cleaner, greener transportation. Well, this week, a video surfaced online showing just how much one particular dealer still doesn't understand about the Chevrolet Bolt EV. The dealer commissioned video in question was about a Bolt EV in stock, and it described the car as having a precision-tuned electric drive engine that would, wait for it, wring every last mile it can out of a drop of fuel. In the dealer's defense, it's likely that this video was produced by a third party using a pre-recorded series of sound bites, but it's still a careless boo-boo that shows just how much work needs to be done before some dealerships really get the message. I'd love to show you a clip of the video here, but sadly the dealership in question has already removed it from YouTube. Guess the embarrassment was just too much, eh? And finally, as anyone who spends any amount of time around an electric car will know, they're pretty high-tech, with more computing power than your cell phone, your laptop computer, and in some cases, your gaming console. You just can't play games on your car. Or can you? You see, video surfaced this week of a Chevy Volt, which had been turned into a Mario Kart controller, allowing the person behind the wheel to play the popular Nintendo game by plugging in a Raspberry Pi running special software into the car's onboard diagnostics port. The result? A real-life game controller inside a real-life car that's cute, but it's something I don't think you should try at home. And on that note, it's time for me to say goodbye again for this week. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Visit transportevolve.com for more cleaner, greener, safer, and smarter transportation news, or join in the conversation on Twitter at @transportevolved. And if you liked what you saw today and you want to help us make more shows like this, please consider making a donation to our Patreon crowdfunding campaign, a link for which I've put in the description below, and there's a clickable link at the end of today's show. Thanks again for joining me. I'll see you next week. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. That was 10. Have a fantastic weekend, and until next time, keep evolving.